Smart cities has been bubbling along for a number of years now, and what we're thinking about now is one particular area of it. We've got cars driving around the road network, gathering loads of data. What are we doing with that data? Nothing. Machine witness, if you imagine, we're thinking of cars in particular as machines, but when we're saying witness, a car might witness an accident, it might witness a crack in the road, it might witness its electricity levels. And what we're doing, employing sort of blockchain consensus mechanisms, is getting multiple cars to contribute so that we can actually get some verification and trust that something has really happened. What we're all doing within Trusted IoT Alliance is demonstrating the value of a data economy and how a data economy can actually work on the road network. We've brought together a whole collaboration. That's one of the most exciting things. We're getting the data from the car via Bosch. Streamr can come along and unlock the value of that car data, and also via its network, help cars to talk to other cars, to talk to roadside units, to talk to the infrastructure that's running the road network. And we're working with Riddle&Code, who provide the hardware wallet functionality to be able to make the car a sort of trusted data source. So between all of us, we're actually, you know, bringing an end-to-end solution where you can actually say you can sell your data, you can get the data out of the car effectively, you can use the car as a trusted data source, and then you can actually have a marketplace to bring all of that together as well.
So the first thing is we need a real electric vehicle. And the way we use it is we have accessed the CAN bus, which is the central network of the car, to be able to access the complete data which the car is producing. And since Bosch has real deep knowledge of all the systems and all the components in the car, we really can make sense out of that data, combining it to maybe new use cases in the future. So what you see here in the rear back end of the car is our prototype vehicle computer that is accessing passively the CAN bus. The CAN bus you only can see here as these cables coming out directly out of the car, connected to all the components in the car and getting all that data what we would like to analyze. And so this vehicle computer is really then transferring that to a hotspot, which have we here on the router, and then supporting it or putting it, transferring it to the world.
The role of the vehicle ID and the wallet is to sign all data coming from sensors and to turn every car into a source of trust.
So as you were driving around Zurich, the car has been generating data, and that's the data you can see now. This is just a raw stream, and if you open now the Streamr canvas, we can see the data in a more visual way. So we can see charts for the speed, steering wheel angle velocity, and also we can see our position here on the map. This is really exciting because you can offer this data on a data marketplace, you can make it available for other drivers, and you can also get money for your data.
So imagine if you had all the cars driving around Zurich all connected and all talking to each other and actually getting all of that intelligence out. What you can then do is actually make people move around the city more effectively.
So what we want to show with this app is that any car, even an older car, can join the network and benefit from other drivers' data. On the app, I can see there is an obstacle on a road. It generated based on the data from the car ahead of us. Now I can slow down and avoid it safely. This app, it's a bit like a Waze, but everyone gets paid for their data. Even older cars can install this app on the tablet or on the smartphone. What really excites me about this app, that it's unlocking the potential of the data that wasn't utilized until now. And it also enables drivers to earn money for their data.
Based on sensor data coming from cars in real time, all of this means that we can optimize road networks, reduce congestion, improve efficiency of traffic systems, and of course also provide better safety for passengers.
We've had the web of data interconnecting. We've now got the internet of cars. We can create something very collaborative, very open, where all sorts of car companies could connect and all sorts of organizations. But the point is, it's collaborative and it's an open ecosystem, underpinned with a flow of real-time data, very fast, with very fast decisions. But that's what I'm excited about, because we're now actually taking the web of data, to the next stage and bringing cars, which are amazing devices, into the mix.